in this chapter we'll be implementing interstitial for improving ad exchange, you know, revenue, CTR and viewability. So we'll be taking care of everything by just implementing interstitial. Now interstitial are user intrusive format, so you know, you kindly consider only implementing interstitial on click event. So I would take you through to the process of doing that. Now we'll be implementing the interstitial in the live website. So guys, I did try this using the, you know, ChatGPT, but it was a nightmare, to be honest. So I would resort to actually going in with the display website, like, you know, the Google website's implementation, because ChatGPT is actually still in nascent stages and it's difficult to communicate and get it right. So it is a tool that you should use it wisely. So right now, without wasting much time, I'm actually going into, you know, this Google's developers website wherein they've shared their implementation of the interstitial. Guys, now let me, you know, explain to you what things we would be needing from this. This is the gpt.js library, so we have already included this in our ad code, so we don't need this. Then you know, this is also included, we won't need this. Then there is let interstitial ad slot, so we would need this declaration. After that, these sections of code wherein we are defining the interstitial firstly would be needed, and secondly we are defining triggers in here. So this trigger specifies when does the interstitial load. By default it loads on the clicks, but we are also specifying that it can load on clicking on the navigation bar, or when you know, unhide the window, go to another window and come back to the new window. So we'll implement these two codes in from here. After that, these all the codes you don't need. This is needed when you don't have any additional ad codes or ad slots implemented on your website. So Google is actually showing an example, but we don't need this. We don't need to define in static slots. Similarly, the CSS isn't needed. The last thing we'll need in here is this script. So that is it, guys. So I have gone ahead and actually, you know, modified this for our website. So it is in our local right now. So let me navigate towards our local. So firstly, I have implemented this declaration, that is this let declaration that we see in here. After that, you know, coming in here, I have gone ahead and implemented this interstitial ad slot code. Now this all remains the same, but what changed is our, like, network ID. So we have replaced in our network ID and our interstitial ad init code. So these are some changes that I made to ensure that, you know, we are seeing the interstitial. And after that, this I mentioned that we only need one more thing from in here is your JavaScript that is being triggered. So we picked this JavaScript from in here and we copy pasted it in here. So this is it. This is all you need to actually serve interstitials. Let's now implement the interstitial that we did on our test site to the live site. So I am actually picking up the code from in here and implementing it in our website. So we have to find the section wherein our head code is located. So code snippets, header and footer. Okay. Script. So one is this interstitial ad slot code. So I am providing it in here. That is cool. Another thing is our variable. Let's copy that as well. Okay. Now lastly, it is the body code of the interstitial in here. we implemented in here. Okay, that is it. We click on save. Let's now verify how the things are happening on the live website just by, you know, performing a Google FC first. Okay. Okay, so this interstitial is actually loading up. Now the interstitial has started to record impressions, and that is how we are sure that, you know, it's serving correctly. So I go in into the account and quickly pull in a report. Okay, so it started to record impressions, so we are aware that interstitial is working.